Afternoon, guys. Okay, so a couple of exciting souls to show you, or exciting is probably the wrong word, but certainly interesting, and probably not for the reason that a number of people would think. So, first one I'm going to show today then is a saw from this gentleman that came the other day, and I think the saws are absolutely beautiful, I have to say, up front. So you're going up on eBay then for spares or repair. Don't know the history of the saw other than the gentleman it's come from. And so I'll explain the problems that she arrived with and then what I've done, which is virtually nothing. So so I said to the guy, I said, look, I said, these are really quite collectible. I think the 444s, out of all the, maybe the 500 saws I've had, I've never cut in earnest with a, I've never cut with a 444, and I think I've only ever had one 44 white top, like the Rancher, and I always think that they perform beautifully when they're configured well. You know, they're beautiful construction, and so I'm a little bit, I'm not sure of the exact specs of these. I presume if it's like the 44, then it's going to have a 42 mil piston with a 32 mil stroke, and it'll be, you know, 44 cc capacity, and I presume this came after the 44, I would think. So I'm thinking then it's a 1980s saw, so that's about where I am with them. And so a couple of his other saws were 136s, 137s, 51s, so I think the 51s from 1990, they're all a bit later for me. So I think the 136s are 98, and the 137s are early 2000s, 2003, 4, that type of era. So anyway, this one, he said, it's not running very well. I said, okay. And he said, it's, even when it's running well, it's not particularly powerful. I thought, okay. So I said, look, I said, the saw is, and it had a broken chain break. So what is she running? She's got a beautiful, absolutely beautiful, this lovely patina. She's got a gorgeous Sandvik Swedish original 15 inch correct guide bar, which looks in lovely condition, roller nose. She has what he told me is a nearly brand new Oregon 325 pitch chain. Looks fantastic. And so she had a broken brake cover, but I had a spare brake cover for one of my Rancher 40s or Rancher 44s, I'm pretty sure, because it's quite distinctive. I wasn't sure what it was actually. It was in a spares box, which I had. And so it's the single stud on the side. And so there you go. So she's found a home, and she was in beautiful condition, unbroken, with the little rubber chain catcher on the inside. So I checked the spark plug, and this is the point I was going to get to. A case in point. Even when you think you've got the right item in your machine, had the correct reach plug in, but with the wrong electrode. And another one for devil for that is things like the steel 08S's or the 07s. You know, there's a reason why you have to have something like the B6HS in that engine. Not just for the extra reach, but also for the extended electrode, so that it burns the fuel off properly and they fire fantastically. So she's had a correct plug put back in, even though the other one's sparking great. Just put the correct plug in. Second thing, which I can't believe the number of mistakes, is the fuel filter. If it's got any discoloration in it, take it out and just throw it away. Don't try cleaning it, or it's such a waste of time, and it eventually just costs you so much frustration, because they're devils for fuel starving on a cheap fuel filter. So I put in a Husqvarna fuel filter. So then, okay, chain brake cover, fuel filter, correct plug, everything else looks beautiful on the saw. Side cover's fantastic, original badges in place, and is that AV mount with that there? Lid's a tiny bit loose, screws in, so it might just be, maybe there's a bush which just sits on that, but top cover's unbroken, and tank looks in great condition, as does the handle. The handle wrap is good. It's an excellent brake. Let me show you how she runs. Kill switch, throttle lock. So she might be a tiny bit lumpy on idle, but idle's upside down, straight from starting off. And okay, she seems to me to have really, really good compression. So I don't know when this was last cut with. Just feeling that then. Is that? So for an AV mount, not spectacularly tight. Guys, let me just grab the spanner for the guide bar nut. Thought I'd tighten that up when I okay. Check the AV mount again. No, AV mates are good. Okay, so right, let's see how she cuts. So she's an unknown commodity for me, but so I'll say it again. If you've got any old engines out there and you're struggling with running characteristics, just never ever overlook the basics, which is even when you think you have a good spark plug, for the amount of trouble they can cause when they misfire under compression, because lots of people don't have a chamber to test them in. Just discard it, put something brand new in it, put a brand new filter in it, and just eliminate those variables straight away. And it makes life so much more enjoyable. So I can't wait to see what this girl performs like. So she made me sharpening, but the chain looks excellent. It's an Oregon semi-chisel chain, and exhaust looks really, really good. She's oiling well. 15 in. Wow, it's tight. It's a great test. Let's see how this girl performs. Just can't wait. Any issue with the cutting, just seems like she's really, really rich at the top end. You just grab a screwdriver and just take a 16th off the turn. So she sounds like she's just a fraction rich.
Uh-huh.
Perception is of what people's perception is of needing a more powerful saw. So that's with the blade fully sunk in, doesn't seem to bog down except right at the very beginning. So obviously set a tiny bit rich, but there you go. Although it's cutting, the chain could, even though that chain is cutting and seems to cut well, it could definitely do with balancing out. It's not, I'm not super proficient on smaller chains, on 325s, so, well, obviously it cuts fantastic, just if you want, you just see a couple of ridges, so maybe it just wants balancing out very, very slightly, and so there she is, that's the Husqvarna 444. Going up on eBay then for spares or repair. So bear in mind then that she's been stood a very long time and she's had a replacement cover, she's had a replacement plug, a new filter, and that's it. She's definitely oiling well, seems to cut well on a restart is... Oh, there. Starts from starting straight into invert, idles upside down, and no damage to the pull start housing. So I would think that's an amazing project saw for somebody just to go through and just make it even better. But as for power, I would have said that cuts so well. Let's take take one more disc off. So, yeah, I'd love to hear any feedback on that. If that's, like I say, that's the first time I've used one. So, I mean, they seem fantastic power to me, but maybe you've seen these cutting even quicker than that. But that's full blade, 15, and of course that's semi-chisel as well. And so, I guess if you wanted faster performance, you could take that out. Yeah, she definitely feels sharp. Just perhaps just needs just maybe just cleaning a touch. So there you go, guys. That's the beautiful Husqvarna 444 SE going up on eBay for, well, either for spares for somebody or maybe just a great project saw to work through completely. And although, you know, for the most part, I think, to my way of thinking, she runs fantastic. Okay, guys, thanks for watching. Love to hear you.